Welcome to the People's Ring. I'm Coach Neighbors, and in this video tonight, I'm going to give you guys a quick update on what punches we about to make tomorrow. I got a couple of things lined up to go down and file. I want to share, one or two I might share the whole thing. One, I'm just going to share the front page or so you guys get the idea. Because, you know, I'm figuring they're watching my stuff, and I don't want them to see my stuff, right? I don't care if they if they call me, I'll tell them what the hell I'm about to stick up in their face. I got no problem. No, I want them. I want them to know what I'm bringing. I'll tell them when I'm coming, and I hope they do their best job stopping me. So far, I ain't heard nothing from them. I know they're probably a little grumpy right now because they're not used to having anybody stand up to them. They're not used to having people stick to facts in their face. They're not used to that. Everybody runs around worrying about this case law and all these rules and all of their crap that, no, we got a different program. Around here, we're on the non-conventional program. And you just need to get the ass in the ring with some stuff. So I'm going to show you what I'm going to be doing tomorrow because who knows, they might name. Oh, I've been punching them all weekend while they all been at home sitting around. I've been making sure that I'm putting myself in the best position possible. So let me do a screen share, and I'm going to show you guys what we got going on up in her. First thing we're going to do is we're going to go in. Okay, so this is what we're going to be taking. And as you can see, I'm still the defendant down here. I got to put defendant under there. You see, I'm still defendant down here. This is a demand to strike. Attorney Christopher Kopecky's bench warrant from the court record and move the case over to state court. Jurisdiction over a dispute filed by a foreign agent not registered with the federal government. And Joseph Kopecky is now a party to the case. And see, that's one of the big keys to what we do here. So we're not really that interested in trying to have the judge rule on stuff because we already know that the judge is being paid by them. So here you go. Now, I like to start out with this jewel right here, this gem right here in the front that says that we're stating in Howlett versus Rose, whatever, and federal law and Supreme Court case law apply to state court cases. So when you file a demand to strike and you're jamming them up because they're in violation of federal law and they're not registered with the Foreign Agent Registration Act, you're supposed to provide a temporary restraining order. Well, okay. According to their rules, the Attorney General is supposed to provide the temporary restraining order. Now, I'm not sure who's supposed to report this because I tried the Attorney General thing. Attorney General was not, oh, wait, I had to sue the Attorney General. the first time around 2017, I had to sue the Attorney General because that's the way they wanted to do it. So the Attorney General wasn't real, was kind of grumpy and was not really ready to help me with this. So what it did was I made my own temporary restraining order. And this one is included in the, this one's a little different because I personalized it for my stuff and I can't file the same stuff y'all file. but y'all can file the same stuff I'm filing. Okay, so what I mean is that I stepped up. So I'm going to include these in the packages. And some of them I just put them in there. It has my name on them still. You have to change that shit. But this is additional fire to address the new strategy that we're using where y'all get to punch them out to knock their ass out at the gate. Then you can kick the shit out of them if you want. If you want to kick them while they're down, I don't care. I'm not going to jump in and blow the whistle. No. So, you know, the way I like to do it, I like to make them sweat. But not everybody likes to do that because some people kind of nervous and stuff, you know, and that's all right. That's all right. Because there's going to be some punching and kicking that you're going to get to do or whatever. So what I did here is I structured this temporary restraining order to block the state from receiving federal funding. Yeah, I spent quite a bit of time one day if I can shut down the court's money. This is what we came up with. Now, how I use this is for leverage to make them like want to tap the hell out, go sit the hell down. So I would wait till you get some stuff shoved in their face and then come in with the restraining order. Once you get your lawsuit or you get something on the record showing that you're challenging them, like I got the demand for sanctions for $20.5 million on their record, I can go in and have a lien and put a lien against a municipal building or a lien against their corporate charter or whatever I want to do, since I have that on the court record already. And so that's one of the things I've been getting a little busy beefing up my stuff. Beefing up my stuff here. So the temporary restraining order is right here, and I'm just going to tell you, I'm going to share it with you. Basically, what I've done is we're demanding that the court, now, this was originally structured to file in federal court to block the funding going to state court. I'm using it in state court to make the state court people block the funding going to them. And so if you watch my instructional videos, you already know that there's a process that we go through whenever the judge throws the shit out. So if they don't agree that the funding should be blocked, then we're gonna address that. Now, the reason we're doing this is because under the spending clause of the Constitution, it mandates that the federal government can block the funding going to the state. All of the federal funding going to the state. If the state is, so once you can prove that they're violating the due process and their day-to-day procedures, the state's day-to-day procedures and policies violate your due process. Starting out with the police officer violating the separation clause, signing the ticket, you know, all the way down. The municipal court don't even have jurisdiction, do nothing. The judge in municipal court has conflict of interest. Oh, wait, the legal professional that was appointed to be a fake judge. That's what I mean. Judge is paid by the state. Everybody's paid. Yeah, so this is the spending clause. It's right there. Gratis. De nada. You're welcome. Now, everyone's like, oh, wait, I need to copy that. Dude, look this shit up on Google. How you think I learned this stuff? Hey, it ain't no secret. This part ain't no secret. I just want to provide it right in there. Oh yeah, we added Miss Kopecky in there. That is the 1-2 punch that we're going to be filing tomorrow. And there's one more. there's one more thing that we're going to file tomorrow. And if y'all notice right here, I'm demanding that they move this shit back over to state court. And the $20.5 million demand for sanctions probably needs to move to state court too, because I added their happy asses to it as litigants, so they can't do shit. That's what I got to say about that. So tomorrow we're going to add this final punch. Okay, this is a notice of recusal for Judge Kopecky under 28 U.S.C. section 455. Judge has a conflict of interest. He's paid by the municipal court attacking me without injured party, and he is a party to the case. So bye-bye. Adios, Mr. Kopecky. Su necesita comprar un abogado para tu ayudar. That means goodbye, Mr. Kopecky. You need to go find yourself an attorney. And when you find yourself an attorney, have your counsel contact my counsel. So that I can have email address to send this stuff to. Notice of recusal. I'm gonna share that with you guys too, because you know I don't play around. And give you guys a little bit of a chance to see how I roll with my stuff. Now I don't use my stuff. I use my new stuff. went in with obstruction of administration of justice. This is how you say people are screwing you over in their when you say you're suing them, whatever, now. You're suing them for the obstruction of the administration of justice and disqualification of the judge. And this is a little bit about all of that. And then we talked about Mr. Kopecky. What the hecky, Mr. Kopecky is not a member of the judiciary bench. I'm not subject to obey him. It's a recorded structure, is a corporation structure to pick up the trash. Mr. Kopecky, I already got people picking up my trash. Doing a damn good job. I think I should thank you, but I don't think you have anything to do with that. So that's pretty much what we're going. Oh yeah. So when you do this, you gotta have a affidavit with it. That's their rules. I only follow the ones that help me. So. Oh yeah, you gotta see my new bling bling too. Yeah, I might take my stuff off and go have a talk with Mr. Kopecky. Oh yeah, I can just see it now, Mr. Kopecky. Do you know who I am? Yeah, it's a tearaway badge, just in case after. I got it down now. Do you know who I am? Y'all scared, right? Oh, I think it's cool as hell. But I guess you can say I'm a policer. Thank you guys for the value of sharing your time. I'll see you in the next video.